Sports. It's in the game. EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air.
Today, boy, what a matchup. Two NFL franchises with so much history, so much tradition, getting set to do battle here, as it'll be the Chicago Bears taking on the Las Vegas Raiders.
Carter now from his end zone and tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. On the ground, it's Jacobs to start the drive, and he'll take this ahead for about 4. Second down coming up.
Brandon, we just saw the benefits of being able to run the ball successfully. They pick up 4 yards on that carry. So now, if you're a play caller, you can do just about anything you want. But on the defensive side of the ball, you scramble a little bit. Now you're behind trying to figure out, do I need to blitz him? Do I need to pressure him? How do I gain an advantage on this snap?
Still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down. Trying to run for it with Jacobs. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. They go with Jacobs. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. Well, we kind of looked at each other as they decided to go for it. But in the end, great execution. A 6-yard gain, and it all works out. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. Off the play fake. O'Connell. Short throw, and that's hauled in by Mayer. Shedding the tackle, that gives him some room. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. Good work after the catch. Going to net him 23 and a first.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down. Oftentimes, your best bet, just jump on and hold on and wait for your teammates to arrive to help get him on the ground.
Oh, ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. And the Bears are going to take possession of the football as they force the turnover on the opening drive. That right there is the inauspicious start that they were hoping to avoid, the turnover on the first possession.
I love how you use those college-bound words like that, inauspicious. Well done. I really appreciate that. But here's the thing for me. I'm just wondering if their game plan is incorrect. You know, I think they felt like they could come in and throw it around pretty well. That interception early, they may rethink how they go about attacking.
They'll run it here. This is Deontay Foreman. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
On second down, here's Fields. And he will find the open man. It's DJ Moore.
It'll go down as a gain of 6. And all of a sudden here, it's third down. I think defensively you're okay with that. Here in the first quarter, he's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that, you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch. Now you put the offense in a position where every series, they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
So still a scoreless game in the first, but they're going to go for this thing on their own side of the field on fourth down.
They snap it to Fields. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete.
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. A curious decision to go for it, but it pays off with a first down. That was a pretty good job by the defense, I thought, right? I mean, they had to go to their check down, but still were able to get it done for the first.
Agreed. Anytime you can force them to come back to a receiver that's a little bit shorter in the route, you've done your job on defense, but still, they pick up the first down and get a fresh set.
Huge fourth down conversion. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays. So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory at the 38.
They'll go again with Herbert.
And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it.
It went right back to him, but he pretty much had nowhere to go on that play.
Yeah, the previous carry looked pretty good. That one, maybe he was a little tired. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he should have tapped out and had a second back come in and maybe make that run. Who knows?
They'll set up the screen for Herbert.
And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play.
We're scoreless after one. The Bears with the football. We get set to begin quarter number two as they've got it with a third down coming up. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. They'll run with Herbert. Boy, no chance as he was met and dropped behind the line there. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one.
Just a simple run play there on third and one, but this D was up to the challenge and stopped him, bringing up fourth down.
On fourth down, Fields. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he is going to have the Bears first down. And they pick it up rather easily. A gain of 9 on fourth and 2.
Give them credit. They knew what they wanted to dial up on fourth. They executed it for 9 yards, and the offense stays out there.
They run it on first with Foreman.
And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. Mark that as a gain of 16 to set him up first and goal.
That's pretty much meat and potatoes right there, wasn't it? Just go right at him and let your big horse charge up the middle. Not too fancy there, was it?
Nothing fancy at all. Challenging that defense. And on that go-around, the offense won the challenge. And he is in. Touchdown, Chicago.
Khalil Herbert.
A 5-yard touchdown run.
And the Bears post the first points of the ball game as they take the lead here in this second quarter.
So important in this league to capitalize on the other team's mistakes. And here they force the turnover on the opening drive, then come right down and score.
And I would add that it's important to capitalize on other teams' mistakes early. That way, you build confidence for yourself and your team. You start playing a little more freely. And you let the other guys know we're prepared to play.
Well, after the touchdown, here's the punter, Trenton Gill, to kick it away. From his end zone, here comes Carter. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
The offense for Las Vegas about set to begin the drive. I remember the last time out, they threw the interception. That led to the touchdown, so now time to regroup.
It certainly is, and their goal right now as they go back out on the field, a calming drive, something that takes the ball, keeps it for a while, lets the defense relax a little bit, lets the offense regain confidence in their game plan.
Now a second and 10. And O'Connell now to throw.
Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Jacobs. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. Give them 12 yards that time and a Las Vegas first.
That's a pretty play there coming out of the backfield. But as that back, you've got to be conscious of making sure you're securing the football. When you get out in open field, sometimes you get a little loose with it as you're trying to get up ahead of steam. Make sure you keep it close to your body because his defenders are trying to punch it free. He does a nice job there protecting the ball and picking up the first down.
Ball on the 39. Here's second and three.
They'll stay on the ground with Jacobs. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a third and two. The good run on first down followed up by a not-so-good run on second down.
Now let's find out if they're going to stick with the run here on third down. A lot of people would love to see some play action here. I say go with your best running play over your best blocker.
They need two. Here's third down. Here's O'Connell. Oh, and his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. Picked off by Jaquan Brisker. And they will score a pick six for a Bears touchdown.
That was a nice catch, and not by the guy you thought it was going to be. How about the defender turning into an offensive player as soon as the ball hits his hands? And off he goes, off to the races, and into the end zone.
Santos now to add the PAT. And it's good to make it 14-0. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away.
From his end zone, here comes Carter. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. The Las Vegas offense ready to start this next drive.
And job one here, Charles, just keep possession of the football. Two drives, two turnovers to this point.
You're exactly right, Doctor. Hippocratic oath, first do no harm. And right now they're harming themselves on offense.
I like that. No one is mistaking me for a doctor, though. But thank you, Dr. Davis.
And the Raider first down. First and 10 at the 40-yard line.
Now they'll change things around before the snap. O'Connell on first and 10.
And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Eddie Jackson picks it.
And the Bears are going to get the football here as he gets this up to the 38-yard line.
Well, I'm not sure that the wheels, Charles, are coming completely off, but they're shaking a little bit. That's three interceptions and now interceptions here on back-to-back drives.
And I think about what a Hall of Fame coach told me that he always told his teams, when a mistake happens, just move on to the next play. Let it go. Hard to do when you've thrown this many interceptions. That's exactly the attitude that has to be adopted.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive.
It's been a good first half so far. They're up 14-0. Points here, that could really put them in command before intermission.
Yeah, and it's all well and good what they're seeing and how they're feeling right now. But it's the NFL. How many times have we watched 14-0 leads evaporate and quickly? So how have we seen them combat it? Continue to run your offense, but don't back off at all. Don't start looking at the clock. Don't start thinking about, hey, just take care of the football. Keep attacking. Usually the best way to maintain control.
They'll set up the screen to Herbert.
A nice little juke. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one.
Here we go, Scott. EQ.
Go. On
first down. Fields
sliding out of the pocket.
That is caught by Herbert.
And he'll cross over out of bounds right at the 25. 25 yards that time.
So many times in my career I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing, but as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
Here we go, shot.
On first and 10, it's Herbert. Down to about the 23.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
Now the Bears going to use the second of their timeouts, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half.
Here we go. Good.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Moore, the motion man right.
He rifles complete. Caught by Moore. Touchdown, Bears! DJ Moore, as the first half is winding down. And the Bears will extend their lead here just before halftime.
Well, Charles, after the first quarter was just complete disaster for them, everything has flipped. I mean, it's 180 degrees in the other direction now here in quarter two.
Championship effort right there. How about them marching almost the length of the field, coming through on their final opportunity to get the win? This is one that this team will remember forever, as well as their fans.
And they'll accept that penalty. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Just 11 seconds to go in the half as they have it first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw.
He'll let this go for Adams.
It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Trying to get something positive to happen here before the break, and they sure need it. They went for the big one, but it winds up incomplete.
Following the incomplete pass, here they go again, second and 10 from the 25. The final shot before break. O'Connell,
he lets it go deep for Mayer.
And this one is incomplete. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down, two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. Set to resume. Here we go with the second half. The Bears holding the lead and ready to receive the kick.
On the return, here's Tyler Scott.
And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20.
Don't jump.
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. Back to throw, Fields. And his throw here is incomplete.
Had an open man that time. We ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. They come up now, third and five, following the incomplete pass. To throw is Fields. That is caught. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Two catches in the first half. Now he's got a third here, and it's good for a first.
That's another beautiful throw right there. It gets it to his man right in stride. And I think that throw kind of exemplifies what we've seen from this offense throughout this game. They've been in rhythm. They've been sharp. They've been on it, and they pick up another first down there.
Hustling through to break that play up, Max Crosby.
And plays like that are exactly what this defense needs here early in the second half to give it a little spark. I think their halftime adjustments, what they talked about, maybe it was just a little inspirational speech. Who knows? But looks like they're ready to go.
This pass on target, Velus Jones with it. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Touchdown, Chicago. Velus Jones, 68 yards. As his guys have opened up a very comfortable lead. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
Now the point after try for Santos. It's good, and they stretch their lead to 28-0 now. After the touchdown, here's the punter, Trenton Gill, to kick it away. From his end zone, here comes Carter. And he returns this to the 22.
The Raiders take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started.
A CD, they certainly know the hole that they face as they begin the second half. They have to do what precious few teams have done in NFL history, and that's try to come back from a four-possession deficit.
And partner, you know, as that team gathers, they're saying to each other, you never say never, right? Because if you're on an NFL roster, that's how you have to think. You can always come back and win a ball game. And let's face it, we saw a certain Super Bowl, a 25-point lead late, that wasn't enough to put someone away. But that being said, this task is near impossible, let's face it. And bottom line is, it officially becomes impossible if this possession is an empty one.
First down throw, O'Connell. Here's back-to-back catches for Devontae Adams. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, first and 10. O'Connell working from the gun. He hits Adams, complete. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. A really nice gain of 25 yards. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Off the play fake, here's O'Connell. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete. So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They've given him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
On second down, O'Connell. That's complete into the hands of Myers. And the Raiders are going to be looking at first and goal as they move this down to the 4-yard line. To the air again with O'Connell.
Escaping the pressure right.
And he's got Renfrow in the end zone. Touchdown, Raiders.
A great effort there with an amazing diving catch.
And the Raiders are able to make some inroads here to that deficit. So a very important first drive of the third quarter, Charles, and safe to say, a much-needed touchdown.
Which leads to the question, where was this in the first half? Because if they'd had a few more drives like that, they wouldn't be in this situation. But that is the kind of drive that sends a message to the other side. We're going to be here, and we're going to battle you to the end.
Extra point by Carlson, up and good. And it's now a 28-7 ball game. Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
Here we go.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And now you've got the clock winding down here in the third quarter. You're three scores to the good. What's your approach on this drive?
Too early to fully commit to playing the clock game. Yet at the same time, you're also not going pell-mell like you would in two-minute offense. This is what NFL offense is called, four-minute football. Take the clock out of the game a little bit, wind it down, but at the same time, keep advancing the ball down the field.
Here's Fields now on second down.
Flushed out right. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Well, that's a good piece of quarterbacking right there because he certainly felt the pressure coming. The alternative, getting sacked for the first time. He didn't like that option at all. Did a nice job saving yardage by throwing that one away.
They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on second down. A shotgun snap, Fields. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up. Here comes the Bears punter now. And the way this offense has moved the ball, he hasn't been needed till here in the third. Here comes Carter. And that one a 55-yard punt, 13 on the return. And the Raiders will take over now, 1st and 10. The offense for Las Vegas about set to begin the drive. I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
Third quarter from Southern Nevada. Here's a 2nd and 10. Back to throw, O'Connell. And he's going to lose yardage here. As they will switch ends as time has run out on this third quarter of play. Back now in Las Vegas. Welcome back, everybody. A lot of folks starting to make their way to the parking lot. Their guys trail big here to begin quarter number four. Third and 19. Now O'Connell.
And pressure coming, and they got him once again.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down.
So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out.
They'll go for it. O'Connell.
And it's going to be batted down. It will go the other way with the football. The Raiders try it on fourth down, but to no avail. And boy, possession here turns over with a football already being in the red zone.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Herbert powering up the middle.
Able to fight for about 4 yards there to the 13.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
On second down, here's Fields.
Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. Give him 5 on the screen play, and that'll set up a third down.
The key to any screen play is all in the deception. That means everyone on the offensive side of the ball. But someone gave it up because that one wasn't very well concealed. And the defense able to rally to him and hold him for just a short gain.
Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with 2 remaining. We'll be back after this.
Here we go, son.
This offense so far on third down, they've only converted once in 4 tries. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd and 1. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up 4th down.
Well, 4th quarter with a 3-score lead here, Charles, but they're still going back to the air and looking for more points.
Well, with this game well in hand, it's an opportunity for the guys to come off the bench and get a chance to play. And a lot of coaches, they want to run their full playbook no matter who's on the field.
And with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on 4th. Now the Bears going to use the 2nd of their timeouts. That's going to leave them with just 1 remaining here in this 4th quarter.
So Fields is off, and on comes Cairo Santos for the Chicago field goal.
From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. And that is no good. And the lead will hold at 3 touchdowns.
Well, they can probably live with that with this late lead in the 4th quarter. That's one of the few things that's gone wrong.
You're exactly right. This one was well in hand. That kick there was more for cosmetics, you know, to add to their score. Not getting it, that shouldn't harm them at all.
On 1st and 10, it's O'Connell.
And a big loss here as he's taken down.
Now this one from about 2 counties over after the sack. They come up on a 2nd and very long.
Here's O'Connell looking to throw it. Open man is Myers.
They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for 3rd down.
And the offense moving quickly to the line.
Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw.
Looking deep for Adams. It got his man complete.
And he will be taken down, but a big play there as it comes just as we reach the 2-minute warning.
Here we go, set. 19 tight, 19 tight,
set, go. O'Connell looking to throw on 1st.
And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today.
And the Bears are going to take over at their own 11-yard line.
All smiles and high fives on that defensive sideline. That interception will cap off what was truly a tremendous performance.
Yeah, if you can hold a team to 7 points in the NFL, that's the kind of day that you feel really good about. Now, I do know a few guys are going to think to themselves, held them to 7. If we'd made 1 more play, could have had our shutout.
Don't jump. Ready?
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. Angel. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all 3 timeouts, but very little reason to use them at this point. And he'll take this one only up to about his 13-yard line. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming 2nd down play.
Here we go. Hey, Cam.
Herbert once more. And he'll use his blockers to get this up over the 20 to the 21. Now the Raiders going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Third down and one. Now it's Fields. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he will have the first down, but he winds up paying for it pretty good. Now the Raiders going to burn their third and final timeout as they'll get it with just under 90 seconds remaining. It's a gain of a yard, and that leads to a Chicago first down. A handoff for Herbert. And this will be a Bears first down as he gets this up past the 30 to the 32.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe they get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason. We've seen it happen in college.
All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. And the Raiders are going to take over a couple of yards shy of midfield. The Las Vegas offense ready to start this next drive. Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things in this ball game, but the self-inflicted wounds, they've had several turnovers. You would have to think that's going to be something they're going to discuss heavily in the film session in the coming days.
You're absolutely right about that, partner, because they're going to have to sit in that film room and watch every error that they made and figure out how to not do it in the future. And mentally, I think a lot of the guys are already starting to think about, okay, how do we put this behind us and get better for the next time out? This, they'll use as motivation for the rest of the time that they play to hopefully never be in this type of situation again.
And now the third down throw incomplete as well.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
One final shot. They'll look to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that will be incomplete as time has run out on this football game. So this one in the win column for the Chicago Bears. And it was their defense that really paved the way to this victory as they allowed the one touchdown, and that was all she wrote.
Almost want to do the defense chant right now, right? Defense with a couple of claps in there, but no one wants to hear that from me. Let's just talk about how they got it done, though. When you take care of every aspect of the game, shut down the run, control the airways, right? Make sure the quarterback is harassed. This type of performance you get. They can't fashion together any offense, no consistency, and they just took control.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hardworking men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. With that, we say so long from Las Vegas.